Hello guys, welcome to my channel. I am Rathin Datta. Today we'll be discussing few definitions that are actually necessary to start preparing for dynamics of machines. In India we call it, simply called it as DOM, that is D-O-M, dynamics of machines. The first thing that comes while start preparing for dynamics of machine is the definition of rigid body. What do you mean by rigid body? Rigid body is such a body which doesn't undergo any appreciable amount of deformation while transmitting the motion. As in case of mechanics of solid, we have considered those bodies that can be compressed or can be given a tensile force, where the body was not rigid. But in this case, whenever the force is applied on that body, there will be no change in the volume of the body. There will be no appreciable deformation in the body. That body, those body are called as rigid bodies. Next to this is the definition of inertia. Inertia is the property by virtue of which the body wants to remain in the position of rest or in motion until a force is applied on it. Okay, and the next two definitions are the static force analysis and the dynamic force analysis. The static force analysis, in static force analysis, we don't consider those inertia forces along with the static forces. But in case of dynamic forces, if we consider those in the dynamic force analysis, if we consider the inertia force with the static force, we can make a dynamic force analysis. Next to this, our fourth definition is the definition of inertia force, and the fifth is the inertia couple. Inertia force is an imaginary force which acted upon a body to bring the body into equilibrium. And in the same way, the inertia torque is that kind of torque which acted upon a body to bring the body into equilibrium. The magnitude of inertia force will be same as the accelerating force, that is force equal to m into a, mass into acceleration, but a negative sign will come, that is your inertia force will be f equal to minus ma. In case of inertia torque, in the same way, it will be T into I into alpha, where I is your mass moment of inertia and alpha is your angular acceleration. Yes. And then next is the radius of gyrations. What do you mean by radius of gyration? If the total mass of the body is concentrated at a certain point, that is called center of gravity, which is at a distance from that distance about which the body rotates, about that axis, that distance is called as radius of gyration or radius of gyrations. It is given by I equal to mk squared, where I is the mass moment of inertia, m is the mass of the body, and k is the radius of gyration. And k can be simply found out as k equal to root over I by m. The next definition that is needed in here is the D'Alembert's principle. It deals with two cases when the resultant force acting on the body passes through the center of gravity, that is the CG, and when the resultant force acting on the body doesn't pass through the center of gravity. If it does pass through the center of gravity, the body will be brought into equilibrium by a force which will be equivalent to this resultant force but opposite in nature, that is your inertia force. In the second case, if the resultant force acting on the body doesn't pass through the CG, it will try to rotate the body about the axis passing through the CG. So this accelerating couple will be balanced using a inertia torque. So we have studied this few definitions: rigid body, inertia. What do you mean by static force analysis, dynamic force analysis, inertia force, inertia torque, radius of gyration, and last, the D'Alembert's principle with two cases, passing through CG and doesn't passing through CG, that is the center of gravity. Thank you so much for being with me, for liking, sharing my videos, and subscribing. Thank you once again. Bye-bye.